record level security. So the first thing is OWD. OWD stands for organization wide defaults, right? And it determines the baseline level of access. It determines the baseline level of access for all the users in our organization for that particular object. Listen to this once again. Determines the baseline level of access for all the users in our organization for that particular object. So that means, let's talk about students. So if we all are the users in the org, and we're talking about student object, we all can see all the records if we have got the access of it on our object level security. So in that case, what would be the OWD? Public read only, right? We all can edit all the records if we have got access to it on the object level security. Public read, right? We cannot read every record. We cannot edit every record, even if we have got the access on object level security. So that's the kind of baseline level of access that you set, determining or considering all the users in your organization. And why all the users? Because as I explained you in that inverted triangle, that first you have to restrict the access from everyone, and then you have to create exceptions to provide the access to the people to whom you want to give the access to. But first, you want to restrict the access from everyone. So remember the example of the bottle and the tripod that I gave to you. To some of the people, I want to give a bottle. And to some of the people, I want to give the access of a tripod. But first, I have to take the bottle and tripod from all of you. So that's restricting the access from all of you, and then creating exceptions to give you the access. Make sense? You can come in here. Like you. There are many seats which are vacant in here. Okay, so with OWD we set the baseline level of access. Is it clear? Okay. Number one thing, if on that particular object a user can access, can read every record and can edit every record, then in that case there is no need to implement record level security at all. And in that case, you can leave the OWD as public read write. I explained it to you earlier as well. Like, is it like that some of the users will let's talk about student object. So whosoever has got the access on student object from object level security, they should be able to see all the records, and they should be able to edit all the records according to the permission that they've got. We do not want only some of the records to be editable to them, or only some of the records to be readable to them. In that case only, like in that case, we'll not implement record level security. And like still we have to set the OWD, which is by default set to public read write. And when you set it as public read write, then that means every user has got a public read write access onto that particular object, which means that the one who has got the read access on object level security will be able to read all the records. The one who has got read and edit access on object level security, that person or that user will get read and edit permission on all the records. And if there is no permission on object level security, then in that case, they'll get no access of that particular object. So that's basically what it is. But yeah, this is what OWD does, whatever you want to call it. Any questions? Anyone? Or let's move on to. Read, edit, I'm talking about in respective to object level security. And read, write, I'm talking about in respective to this record level security. That's the only difference. There's no other difference. Anything else anyone wants to ask? Or shall we move on to how to set OWD for a particular object? Or before then that, how to determine what will be the OWD for this particular object, right? Okay. So now the next thing that I'm explaining you guys over here is how to determine what access level you'll set for a particular user in OWD over here, right? So there is a flow chart which Salesforce has provided for the administrators to determine that what permission you're going to give on the OWD depending on the situation. So there is Question one. Write down, what is question one? Who is the most restricted user? Who is the most restricted user for this object? Who is the most restricted user for this object? Got it? Who is the most restricted user for this object? So in your organization, you have to look for that person who should have the most restricted access to this particular object. Let's talk about our business, like institute, right? In an institute, who is we're talking about, and by the way, OWD is set for each and every object. So you first have to take that object for which you want to set it. So I'm taking it as student. So who is the user in your organization who will have the least access on the student object records? Associate faculty, you can say, or front desk executive, you can say, right? Or let's say associate faculty it is. So one of the associate faculty, you can name it over here, like Shrey. So Shrey is the person who needs to have the most restrictive access to this particular object, or who should have the least access on student object in our case, right? So that's the answer of the first question, and based on that you'll have to answer another question. Question two. Write down, what is question two? Is there ever going to be an instance? Is there ever going to be an instance of this object? Is there ever going to be an instance of this object that this user shouldn't be allowed, that this user shouldn't be allowed to see SEE? Is there ever going to be an instance of this object that this user shouldn't be allowed to see? Can anyone explain me what this question means? Repeat, please. Anyone else? Okay, let's divide this into parts. Is there ever going to be an instance of this object? Right. Ever going, okay. Instance of an object. What is an instance of an object? Record. So is there ever going to be a record? Is there ever going to be a record that this user, which user? Shrey. Right? We have selected the most restricted user. That this user shouldn't be allowed to see. So that means, like, is there ever going to be a time in which Shrey will not be allowed to see any single record, any of the one record of student object? Is it true? Like, that can happen? Like, we do not want Shrey to view this student's record. If that is true, Then in that case, the sharing model would be private. So is there ever going to be an instance of this object? Means, is there ever going to be a record that this user, which user, Shrey in this case, is not allowed to see or shouldn't be allowed to see? That okay, let me explain it to you in Hindi once again. Kya kabhi aisa koi record hoga student object ka jo is user ko hame nahi dikhana hai? Agar haan, so in that case the sharing model would be private. Agar na, to fir hum aage baat kare. Theek hai? Na ka matlab ki nahi, aisa to koi bhi record nahi hoga. Shrey to sare record dekh sakta hai student ka. So that's what it is. Let me repeat it once again in English. Is there ever going to be an instance of this object? That means, is there ever going to be a record that this user shouldn't be allowed to see? That means, like, is there going to be a time where you've created a student record and you don't want this user to see that record? If yes, then make the sharing model as private. That means set the OWD as private for student object. Else we'll figure out something else. No, we want the user to see all the records of student object. In that case, we'll move on to the third case. Is there ever, write down question three. Is there ever going to be an instance of this object? Is there ever going to be an instance of this object that this user shouldn't be allowed to edit? Is there ever going to be an instance of this object that this user shouldn't be allowed to edit? Right? Okay. Is there ever going to be an instance of this object that this user shouldn't be allowed to edit? Now let's bifurcate this question. Is there ever going to be an instance of this object? Again, what? Is there ever going to be a record that this user shouldn't be allowed to edit? The only difference between question 2 and question 3 is see and edit. So that means read and write. So in this third question, we are determining that is there ever going to be a record that this user shouldn't be allowed to edit? And that means we've got 100 records. We've got 1,000 records. We've got 10,000 records. Is there ever going to be a single record that we do not want Shrey to edit? If yes, then the sharing model would be public read only. If no, public read write. We want this user to edit all the records. In that case, it would be public read write. If we do not want this user to edit even a single record, like, there are 10,000 records and we want him to edit 9,999 records, but we do not want him to edit one record. In that case also, the sharing model would be public read only. Getting it? So first, hiding the access, and then providing the access. That's what we do. And at OWD, we set the baseline level of access, which determines the access for each and every user in our organization. And why baseline is determined by the most restricted user? Like, most restricted user is the one who will have the least access. And we are setting that least access for all of the people. And then we are going to create exceptions to give additional access to different people or different group of people. Clear? Okay. Let's do this once again. So what's the first question, Prateek? What was the first question? Most restrictive access. So who is the most restricted user for this particular object? You have to select that user, right? And then after selecting that user, you have to ask yourself a question. Is there ever going to be an instance of this object that this user shouldn't be allowed to see? And that means, kya kabhi aisa ek bhi record hoga jo ye user dekh nahi sakta? If yes, then in that case, set the sharing model as private. So that's what it is. And if no, then in that case, we'll go to the third question. And if we are setting it as no, then that means, no, this user is allowed to see every record of this object. That's what we are saying if you are telling no for question two. And then we go to question three. And when we go to question three, we ask ourselves, is there ever going to be an instance of this object that this user shouldn't be allowed to edit? That means, kya kabhi aisa ek bhi record hoga jo ye user edit nahi kar payega? Agar haan, toh iska apan sharing model kya set kar denge? Public read only. Aur agar na, nahi ye saare edit kar sakta hai bhai. Toh hum kya edit kya kar denge? Public read. Make sense? So this is how you determine the like OWD setting for each and every object in your data model or in your application. Is it clear? Okay. So for student, what you have determined? Most restrictive user. Who is the most restrictive user? Associate faculty is a profile. You tell me the user. Shrey. There is no user named as Shrey in your org. Asha, right? Amit Shah. Amit Shah is the one who is on associate faculty profile, and he should have the least access on student object. So you have selected Amit Shah. Now let's talk about it. Do you want Amit Shah or like, is there ever going to be a record that Amit Shah shouldn't be able to see? So if the answer is yes, then in that case, you can set it as private. If the answer is no, then you'll go to third question. And let's say the answer is no. Now we have come to the third question. Now, is there ever going to be a record that Amit Shah will not be able to edit? Yes? Yeah, I mean, according to the object level security, Amit Shah cannot edit the record. But yeah, I mean, in this case also, like it's public read only, because he is not allowed to edit any of the records. So the baseline level of access is set as public read only. Okay, so in my case, I have put some stars on that table, if you remember. Over there, I've written like these associate faculties will be able to see records of a particular course only, or of the students who are registered for a particular course only. So I want to keep it as private, right? I want to keep it as private. How I'm going to do that? Okay, so here are the steps. Here are the steps with the help of which you set the OWD. Let's have a look. Go to setup, and then sharing settings. Edit. Student, private, public, read only, and read write. So I'll set it as private. I'll say that's it. That's how easy it is to set OWD for a particular object. Now it will take some time to like process all the records, because and depends on the number of records. If there are so many records in your object, then in that case it will take a lot of time. And if there are not that many records in your object, then it will not take that much of the time. Right? That's how it goes. And yeah. So once you have set the OWD, what do you think, Akash? There is no Akash. Amit Shah will be able to do. Sorry. He'll not be able to see any record? He'll be able to see the records he owns. So we'll go to user. Amit Shah is here. I'll just copy his username. Amitra is the associate faculty. I'll go to students. Select all. There's no record which Amit Shah holds. Let me do something. Let me make him an owner of any of the records. Cinderella. Amit Shah. Change the. So now, who's the owner of Cinderella record? Will he be able to see the records? Right? He's able to edit the record as well. Because he's the owner. Irrespective of what the record level security you have set. So that's what I'm trying to explain. Is it clear? Okay. So we have set the OWD in our organization. And now, like, we have set the baseline level of access for student object. Now we want to open up the access using the different, using other tools that we have got in record level security or under record level security.